heart break, your break, your heart is broken, it means you are expecting this and it turned out to be something else. So heartbreak is just disappointment. Don't look at it from, it's just disappointment, but it's not normal disappointment. It's a huge disappointment. Usually it is even rude, very, very rude. And then you don't only get disappointed at the person, you also get disappointed at yourself. Hey, what have I been doing? And when you break up, all of a sudden you observe, the person has behaved. You begin to see all the weaknesses. Like, heartbreak, if not controlled very well, can make you to lose your passion, can make you lose focus, can make you lose interest for another relationship. Heartbreak can make you fail in school. Heartbreak can cause you not to sleep. Heartbreak can make you not to be productive. Whoever broke your heart, man, you hate everything related to that person. No, I think already, you hear someone say, Biron guys, I hate Biron guys. It's because of one Biron guy. Then you just hate all Biron guys. Reasons why you face heartbreak. Listen, because if you know the reason, it will be easier for you to avoid them. Okay? One of the reasons why we experience heartbreak is carelessness. We are so careless. Very, very careless. See, relationship is not made for careless people. You have to be careful mentally and otherwise. You will become so careless that you become insensitive. Your carelessness kills your sensitivity. So guess what? You will not become sensitive to those signs that this is coming to an end. You will not become sensitive that you are really messing up. You will not become sensitive that the person is getting tired of you because of your carelessness. Let me tell you this lie that has led to a lot of heartbreaks. They'll lie to you that if you're entering into a relationship, enter with one leg in, one leg out. That has led to a lot of heartbreaks. It's a lie. It's a lie. One leg in, one leg out. And they'll tell you, it sounds sweet, that one leg in, one leg out, so that if it doesn't work, you just gently, okay? Relationship is not try your luck, like try an arrow. Well, let me try, if it doesn't work, I forget. I love rice, she loves rice. That does not mean we are compatible. I love yellow, she loves yellow. It does not mean we are compatible. I'm in Equa, she's in Equa. It doesn't mean we are UJ, she's in UJ. I love action movies, she loves comedy. I love it! That's not compatibility. Compatibility is the ability to be able to tolerate each other's differences. She loves cartoon. I love action movie. When she's watching cartoon, I have the ability to enjoy the cartoon with her. That's compatibility. I love action movies, she loves comedy, but she has the ability and tolerance to watch action film with me and she'll still enjoy it. That's compatibility. Compatibility does not mean doing things same way. Jesus said, love your neighbor as thyself. What it means is loving yourself is the standard at which you should love others. If you've never taken yourself to Mr. Biggs, don't take your girlfriend to Mr. Biggs. But I'm not joking, if you cannot buy a car for yourself, don't buy a business car. If you cannot buy it for a car, okay. Let me make it, okay? Look at it. If you don't know how to love yourself, it is not possible to be able to love the right person well. That's what Jesus was trying to say. You should learn to not love yourself before you can extend same love to the other person. Hear me carefully. If you don't have joy, you can never share it. You can't. That is what relationship is about. You first. If you are not happy, you cannot share the happiness. So men don't play with you because they don't have a point of interest with you. When the man's life is all about banking, he's a banker. He has been banking for 14 years, 13 months, 2 weeks. You understand? You understand banking system and all that. You did catering school. You are very good at cooking. When you sit down, how can he be laughing with you? So he will be telling you, you see the economic recession of Nigeria has some, maybe then you just... be talking when the pot is hot. That's when you put the granite oil and then you can't. So guess what? Look at it, guys. Guess what? That is the compatibility I was talking about. When he has the ability to be able to tolerate and enjoy the fact that, hey, you cook. How do you go? I want to learn to go. Let's go to the kitchen. I've never cooked. How do you do it? Okay, hot water. Okay, he's enjoying it. Compatibility. It's not something that he likes, but he enjoys it because you are the one doing it. How's banking? Oh, I heard there's one called book called Ledger Book. How's Ledger Book? There's red line. Okay, red line. I don't remember the whole David. You are interested in it. You are compatible. If you are not enjoying a man, it's boring. I mean, imagine when you marry, you just watch, you just be. Then when we come to visit your people. You know, come, don't wait. Hey, boy, the guy to me said, hey, hold on, we go, Jesus. Okay, to bye bye. We go, then just. It depends on the circumstance. There is no basic and one formula to end the relationship. There's no one formula that every situation must follow the same way. But I'm giving the basic procedure, okay? So don't send texts. Make sure you see the person one-on-one. Tell the person your worries, your fears. I'm worried that this relationship, or I'm worried that, honestly speaking, I've seen this lady and it's drawing me. My worry is if we continue this relationship at the end, and okay? So make sure you do that. And the next step is, before you break up, start with what is called separation. Like, please, sweetheart, I think we need to have a break because I have a lot of issues that may affect this relationship. I don't think I'll be able to be faithful, so I want to go back and examine myself, sit down. If I'm coming back, I'll come back wholeheartedly, but if I'm going, we'll know how to sort it out, okay? So make sure you tell the person the exact thing. See, don't ever lie. What hurts more in heartbreak? Lies, deceptions. For instance, she's my girlfriend. Okay, this is her friend. Then I'm eyeing her. Woo-hoo. She has what's the other kind? Gown. Okay. I love girls' gown. So she's also gown. So it's man. So I'm their friends. Okay. Then I'm in a relationship with this lady. See, if you're breaking up, tell her the truth. Like this. Be very respectful about it. I have a serious problem. I've been listening to you. I respect you. I love you. You're tall. I love your what? I love her eyeballs and all that. Tell her the truth, what you love about her. Then tell her, but honestly, I think I have an issue that may not make me faithful to this relationship. Honestly speaking, your friend, I've been attracted to your friend. I'm so sorry. I know right now I'm stupid, I'm idiot, I'm very, very stupid. Insult yourself from A to Z, okay? If she slaps you, slap yourself back, okay? If she slap you, pow! Say, babe, you are right, pow! That's how you should do it. Do some more, pow! Accept all, that's what I'm trying to say. Now, when you tell her, look at it, let me tell you the heartbreak. When you tell her that, babe, I think I have to take a break. She was like, why now? She said, no, that you know nothing this. Then she said, okay. Then she later finds out that I am dating her. She'll be hot. No, seriously, it's true. She'll be very, very hot. Now, if I told her earlier, she'll still be hot. But it won't be as haunting as when she found out herself. So the truth is, before you break up, tell them the truth. Tell them, this is it. I always have problems with people that, if any one of you here is my client, you will know that has always been our policy. If you're here and you wanted to break up with your boyfriend, you know I've always told you, go and meet them, sit down with them, tell them the truth. One girl said, it's only his kiss. She, her mouth smells, she can't kiss. No, and he loves kissing. But who wants to kiss? I say, my brother, go and tell her the truth. Are you very sure that that's the only problem? The guy was ready to swear with the Holy Bible that that's the truth. Good. Okay, then it's true. Go and tell her. Maybe she'll take care of it. Maybe. I'm not saying. It can be treated medically. So maybe you can also. So if that's treated, you see, this issue can go on. So but if you go with it in your mind, you understand? And then imagine she finds out that I've told her that I'm mad at me. That's why they leave her. Then she finds out from this. Imagine how hot she'll be. No matter how it is, tell them this is it. With respect. Lastly, when you leave, when you break up, okay, at that moment you'll be hot. So they know what to do to have them to do with you, okay? When they are able to settle down and all that, please relate back to them as friends. It's very, very important.